When I first got into video games, I was floored by the amount of writing that would be necessary in order to build these worlds. For instance, when I did Elder Scrolls, I think I wrote 5 novels worth of writing. Unlike a novel that you read from start to finish, in games we have these pesky things called players, and they will try and do things you didn't expect them to do. And so we had to write in such a way as to always give them something interesting to do if they decided to go off the beaten path. I would say before I ever wrote my first novel, I may have put well over 1 million words down that never went into a novel that got published. There's a giant team of people who are working on the product. The idea that one person's view or vision is going to actually make it all the way to the end, it's not the best form of creative development. You want your best artists doing the artwork, and you want your best writers writing things, and you want your best designers coming up with the things that they come up with. What you get, you hope, is better than the sum of any single person's contribution. But writing is a very singular, private thing, and I found myself, after a number of video game titles under my belt, loving the collaborative process I got during the day, but at night wanting to do something for myself. And writing was that escape. Having dozens of characters all living inside of me and seeing how they eventually make it onto the page, I use some of the tips and tricks that we use in video games development to organize what is a chaotic creative process. One of the things I have adopted for novel writing is conflict maps. In video games, I used to create conflict maps of characters, and I'd be looking for triangles. Once I put all these people down as nodes on a sheet of paper, those triangles meant a conflict moment if they met. It's hard to remember all the places which you have opportunity when you're writing. It's just so vast. Whenever I was at a loss for what was going on, or I was about to write a chapter, I knew which characters were going in. I would just look at my conflict map and say, where's there opportunity for conflict, and how can I work it in? So that was a process that really helped me tie down the way in which I had these characters come to life.